Well, Jarrad, welcome to SANFL TV. Obviously got pretty close last year in the elimination final against North Adelaide, but knowing you beat them twice in the minor round, I guess you know your best is good enough.
Yeah, certainly, Zach. We had a pretty solid year last year. We found some players and got a bit of momentum at the right time of year coming into to finals. And, yeah, unfortunately, couldn't get the job done on Sunday out of the elimination final against North Adelaide. But look, we've maintained a pretty healthy list, and we've learnt, you know, from probably some of the mistakes we made, but certainly from the younger players that got some exposure in finals, and will certainly hopefully take us through to another final series this year.
You touched on learning from the mistakes. Obviously it's your second year in the helm now here at South Adelaide. What do you think you've learned from that first year that you might put into place in year two?
Probably not really more mistakes, it's probably more continuing to back your junior development in and not being afraid to give your young players a go who are in good form. Mm. We certainly found with nine or 10 debutants last year to the club, you know, all of underage of 20, certainly held their own with good senior leadership around them. So, you know, certainly we've got another good batch of juniors coming through this year, and, you know, look, if they're going to be in good consistent form in the reserves, like, there'll certainly be an opportunity for them to play, and I think we just got to continue backing them in.
Significant blow to lose the co-captain Keegan Brooksby, obviously ruckman at the Tizer team of the year, and massive influence in the ruck, but also big Alex Arruccio, Nathan Kruger, and also Tommy Field. So you've lost some tall timber there. Who can we expect to sort of come in and help with replacing that?
Yeah, so obviously, you know, Brooker's deserved another opportunity at the AFL level. He had a tremendous year, you know, on field especially, as well as off field for the football club, and he goes with the utmost blessing, and hopefully he gets an opportunity. So obviously the three other players of Krugs has obviously got an opportunity at AFL level. You know, Fieldsy and Big Rooch have gone back over to Queensland together and playing at Southport, so we wish them well. But we've certainly added some quality tools that we think will play a good role for us this year at SANFL level. Michael Noel, 205 centimetre ruckman from Box Hill. He's only been playing footy for a couple of years. He's an Australian. He's been over in America for 4 years playing college ball. He's been back for the last two, starting his football career, and he's only 25, so he's still plenty of time for him to develop. And he's showing some good signs on the track at the moment with his athleticism. And Hayden McLean is another tall timber that was Vic Metro vice captain a couple of years ago in under 18s. Didn't quite get the opportunity to get drafted, and again missed this year after playing some pretty good football in the VFL. So he sort of comes in to replace Nathan Kruger as a really ready-made 20-year-old who's got some state league experience.
And you've added to your speed nicely by recruiting Malcolm Karpany to the footy club from West Coast Eagles. And then, of course, great to get a former Panther back in Emmanuel Ira once he was delisted by the Magpies as well.
Yeah, well, I mean, you sort of always, you know, you hope you get players drafted, and certainly from, you know, building a good culture at the club over the last 4 or 5 years, it's getting those players back into the club, which, we're stoked to have Emmanuel back. And, you know, probably the top-end teams of the SANFL for the last 4 or 5 years with, you know, Nord and the Eagles seem to be replenishing their stocks with AFL talent coming back after 5 or 6 year stints. And we haven't been lucky enough to sort of have those, I guess, free recruits come back in a sense, if you put it that way. So Emmanuel's the first of the bunch, and obviously we had a few drafted this year, and if they don't quite get the opportunity in the next 3, 4, 5 years, we'll, you know, overly welcome them back. But Emmanuel's been terrific on track. His leadership has really grown since he's been in the Port Adelaide system, and his understanding of probably more defensive actions and setups has certainly grown. And we're hoping to really release him through the midfield with some speed in the front half, along with Malcolm Karpany, who's a quality player. Didn't quite probably get to his full potential at West Coast with some niggling injuries over these last couple of years. But again, at 22, 23 years old, he's probably really in his prime now. So hopefully we see that at South Adelaide this year.
You mentioned backing in some of the youth in terms of the lessons learned and just going again next year. Who are some of the young players here at South Adelaide we can expect to perhaps push up and play a bit of statewide Super League footy?
Yeah, so Jaden Kapler obviously debuted late last year and had a pretty good last 4 or 5 games of the year, and we're really hopeful that he'll come on. He's had a bit of a slower start to the year, but we're hoping that he's going to really come on and play some good football for us. Jackson Elms debuted last year against the Crows, and he's had a terrific pre-season. He's bigger and stronger. He's just turned 20, but he's a really speedy, agile forward that can play tall or small, so we're really hoping that he can come on. Hayden Sampson, unfortunately, didn't get his opportunity, you know, via rookie or draft, you know, in 2018, and he again showed what he can do in his league debut against Port Adelaide last year. So he's had a terrific pre-season. He's bounced back from the disappointment, I guess, mentally from not getting an opportunity. But, you know, his development over the pre-season has been terrific, and probably one of the more dark horses that, you know, is certainly in our development range. But Reece Milsom is one that I find is probably, you know, looking to probably play some league football at some stage this year if he continues to show what he is on the track.
Well, Jarrad, we certainly look forward to seeing those guys push up and play some footy in the Statewide Super League for 2019. Good luck and all the best.
Thanks, Zach.
Welcome to SANFL TV, Hayden. Why make the move to come here and play in the SANFL Statewide Super League?
Yeah, I think last year I had a reasonable year with the VFL, and I stuck with the Lion Club with St Kilda. And I thought there was an opportunity in another league, another state comp. And then talking to Brody Secker, who's played, I think, 5 or 6 years here. I played with him last year and had a chat with him at the end of last year after having a, you know, reasonable year and just missing out, thinking, where can I go for my next opportunity? And then I thought he had a really good time here. He knew the comp was really, you know, high quality as well. So I thought, you know, make the move, new challenge on and off the field, see what I can get out of it.
Obviously here at South Adelaide, a wonderful opportunity with you too, with co-captain Keegan Brooksby leaving amongst several other big guys. So, yeah, there's a great chance for you to push through.
Yeah, that was definitely another thing that was captivating to come here was, you know, Krug again picked up as well as that high forward, and Brooks as well in the ruck. So there's that two positions to be filled. Michael Noel's come down, I think, to play ruck predominantly, and I'm kind of that forward, you know, hidden for ruck as well. But with those opportunities opening up, I thought, why not take them? You know, come down and try to be a key part in this team, and see what I can get out of it.
For Panthers fans, for their benefit, how would you describe yourself as a player, and what are your strengths, and who you, perhaps might you have modelled yourself on in terms of an AFL player?
Yeah, well, I'm more of that, you know, centre forward, that in between full forward and the back line to get that connection going. I like to try and model my game off Nick Riewoldt, you know, that running up and back. Getting back, but also got that contested marking side on me, which I like to use.
And you touched on, obviously, some AFL scouts were sniffing around last year for you. Ideally, have a good season here with South Adelaide, and you never know, you might push your name in front of them again.
Yeah, definitely. You know, that's the dream, to get to that next level at AFL, you know, whatever it is. So putting myself in the best position and the best team, which I think we've got here, to hopefully showcase a little bit of my ability and, you know, yeah, be in front of them.
Hayden, thanks very much for your time on SANFL TV. All the best in 2019.
Perfect, thank you.
Well, Malcolm, welcome to SANFL TV. You must be excited to get into it back here in the Statewide Super League. Why choose South Adelaide as your new SANFL home?
Yeah, well, coming back from the West, I just wanted something new, a bit of a, you know, change in scenery. Being Woodville West Torrens before I got drafted, great club. Knowing Jarrad from back then as well has probably influenced my decision to come here to South Adelaide.
You speak of your relationship with the coach, Jarrad Wright. Obviously that played a huge influence in your decision. What are some of the things you remember from him playing a part in your development before you were drafted by West Coast?
Yeah, absolutely. So I played 2 games under him when he was reserves coach. So having that relationship really helped my decision. Didn't know too much about him, but yeah, I guess that having been under him really influenced it.
Obviously, we knew before you left, when you were here with Woodville West Torrens, and also when you were at West Coast, really classy sort of medium to small forward type. Do you hope here at South Adelaide you might be able to push a bit further up the ground, even onto the wing and the nice wide open deck here at Flinders University Stadium?
Yeah, absolutely. It's a big ground here, which is probably going to help my role. Hopefully I can play up in the wing. As you mentioned, last couple of years I've played that role. So I'm looking forward to this season and what it holds. So,
and the wing, why do you think that might suit you in terms of your strengths as a player?
Yeah, well, I like to, you know, work hard. So I guess that work rate both ways, offensive, defensive. So using my speed as well. So get out into the open space, get the footy and use it well.
And don't mind a goal.
Yeah, don't mind a goal.
Thanks very much for your time. We do appreciate that, Malcolm, and all the best for 2019.
Cheers.